Mastin Kipp's Reclaim Your Nervous System, a guide to positive change, mental wellness, and post-traumatic growth, read by the author. To Magic, the best boy there ever was. Thank you for being my guide, for being my ventral tether, for being my glimmer, and showing me, through just being who you are, how to reclaim my own nervous system and find my joy again. Foreword by Dr. Frank Anderson. In a world that's ailing and struggling to heal from an array of traumas, both past and present, Mastin Kipp's new book, Reclaim Your Nervous System, brings clarity and light with a clear path forward to thrive beyond adversity. He makes a bold attempt to bridge two worlds that have been fragmented and divided for decades, coaching and psychotherapy. Many in the field of psychotherapy focus on the past and don't value what the coaching community brings to trauma-informed care. Many coaches, on the other hand, focus on setting goals and moving forward and hold a legacy of inferiority when it comes to treating people who suffer from relational trauma. In the world of social media today, there's an explosion of therapists, coaches, and influencers who are trying their best to meet the demands of people who are suffering from various forms of trauma. Who is qualified to treat those who have been violated by another? What are the regulations and guidelines when it comes to treating trauma? I can say that it is delicate work and requires a specialized skill set. Sitting with trauma and the level of vulnerability it activates in someone who has been violated comes with a risk of re-traumatization if done incorrectly. I've participated in many consultations with therapists and coaches alike where treatment has gone awry. I know therapists with their appropriate degrees and licenses who should not be treating clients who suffer from trauma. And I know coaches who have the skill set and knowledge base to safely navigate the treacherous waters of healing. It's not the degrees they have or the titles they hold that makes one a good trauma specialist. It takes drive and determination. One needs to integrate theories and neuroscience knowledge with personal and clinical experience to be qualified to help someone else heal. One must be attentive to their own history and self-aware enough to know when it's okay to proceed and when it's time to seek supervision. Most of us are drawn to this field not only because it's interesting and we want to help others, but because we've had personal experiences with trauma, either through a loved one or in our own lives. It's clear that Mastin has done his homework. He's read the studies, explored the models, sought out consultation, worked one-on-one with clients, and has done personal work. He is a change agent, which can feel empowering in one moment and terrifying in another. I know it's been lonely for him at times, working as a coach with clients who have suffered from trauma in a sea of therapists and ivory tower academics. Reclaim Your Nervous System is a bold attempt and a big step forward, providing a clear map for helping therapists, coaches, and healers assist those who are carrying hurt and pain from the experiences they've gone through in life. Mastin describes the importance of moving toward the responses and reactivity associated with trauma as opposed to suppressing, denying, or exiling it. He talks about the value of a parts-oriented approach, which taps into the brain's capacity for state change, helping clients separate who they are from what happened to them. Knowing that splintering off into parts is an essential survival strategy during the trauma, Mastin describes harnessing the capacity for compartmentalization as a tool for helping individuals navigate their way through the healing process. He talks about the value of going back and revisiting the trauma as opposed to approaches that support cognitive override or rely on top-down strategies that suppress emotional expression. Mastin also shares personal stories about his healing journey, which demonstrates the importance of doing your own work in order to assist another in their healing process. We can't help others get beyond their trauma if we're unwilling to go to those places ourselves. I believe that this is one of the most important qualities in assessing the capacity of a healer, the interest and desire to look inward and do their own work in the service of helping others. Reclaim Your Nervous System not only helps us understand the importance of looking back and being curious about the past, but it also helps us explore the fears and challenges of moving forward into the future. Mastin states that both are necessary, in addition to our capacity to be present with the overwhelming feelings that were a result of the injury. He states that moving forward can be as challenging as going backward and offers a new approach that incorporates both. He talks about confounding factors that must be considered when dealing with complex PTSD such as cultural, gender-based, socioeconomic, and racial inequities, along with transgenerational injuries. The model Mastin puts forth, functional life coaching, is a path forward that is holistic and neuroscience-informed, includes looking back, states the importance of being present, and describes how to move ahead with clarity and alignment. It talks about working with distorted beliefs while monitoring our clients' allostatic load, helping them expand their capacity to tolerate distress and release what no longer serves them. It's based in the key principles of polyvagal theory, showing the importance of co-regulation emotionally, somatically, mentally, and socially, while focusing on the corrective emotional experience, a key component to releasing trauma. It also talks about redecision, leveraging one's purpose, and congruence as an important components of the transformational process. Mastin, who has at times felt like an outsider, both personally and professionally, has written a book that incorporates the theories of thought leaders from the past, includes neuroscience knowledge and trauma-centered models in the present day, and offers hope on how to move forward, paving the way for trauma survivors to live an aligned, purpose-driven life. Who knows? Maybe 20 years from now, the next generation of healers will be referencing Mastin Kipp's Reclaim Your Nervous System as they take on the charge of expanding the capacity to bring more trauma healing to the world. With love and gratitude, Frank G. Anderson, MD, co-author of the Internal Family System Skills Training Manual and author of Transcending Trauma and To Be Loved. Invocation. A day will come when you will be stirred by unexpected events. A part of you will die, and you will begin to search for the elixir that will bring this part of you back to life. You will seek the elixir in friends, lovers, enemies, books, religions, foreign countries, heroes, songs, rituals, and jobs. But no matter where you look, the treasure will evade you. All will seem lost, and you will lose all hope that this magic potion even exists. This will be the darkest of nights, and the promise of certain death will lead you to the abyss of despair. But staring into the abyss, you will see the dim light of your own illumined soul. Your radiance will transform the abyss into the elusive elixir of life, and for the first time you will realize that all the while, it was your own light that you've been searching for. Read this first. One does not become enlightened by imagining figures of light, but by making the darkness conscious. Carl Jung. Here's something fascinating I've noticed in 20,000 hours of coaching clients and hundreds of thousands more on my own personal development journey. We human beings may be able to send rovers to Mars, but we struggle to sit with ourselves. It seems to me like we should have solved this problem already. We certainly have every tool we could ever need. And yet, we're all asking ourselves the same question. How do I love myself? In trying to answer this question, I bet you, like me, have been working on yourself with coaching, therapy, energy healing, biohacking, psychedelics, meditation, seminars, and books. You've collected enough PDFs for life, but you still feel stuck. You wonder how it's possible to have done all that work but still find yourself in the same old patterns. Cue the self-judgment, blame, shame, and guilt. But let me begin with this truth. It's not your fault. The answer lies in your nervous system. It's your nervous system that is replaying what happened to you, keeping you stuck and making it seemingly impossible to level up in your life. The nervous system is one of the strongest motivators for human behavior, influencing everything you feel, think, and do. Your nervous system can drive you to create your fullest life, and it can keep you from moving forward. I've worked with thousands of clients in exactly this scenario. I train therapists, psychiatrists, and psychotherapists. I don't have any certifications or degrees, but I can go toe-to-toe with the best researchers and practitioners in neuroscience to push the field forward with healthy debate. What I do have is an extensive knowledge base. I'm a walking encyclopedia with 20,000 hours of practice using that knowledge to help people improve their lives. I love academia, and I also recognize there's an important difference between what I do and what researchers in the halls of academia do. If my tactics don't work, I go out of business. In all my coaching, I focus on helping clients create positive change. If you're like the incredible, courageous individuals I've worked with over the years, these assumptions will feel familiar. You might think that if you're doing this work, you shouldn't be getting triggered or experiencing emotional blocks. Your goal in this work is to amplify your positive emotions, and you'd like to avoid the negative ones as much as possible. What if I told you that by chasing these goals, you've been avoiding some of the most important data for your development? What if I told you your triggers, emotional blocks, and resistance to negative emotions are the gateways to your next level? Maybe you'd rather stop listening to this book than believe those ideas. After all, there are coaches who focus on helping people feel their positive emotions, like Dr. Joe Dispenza with his quantum healing work, or Tony Robbins asserting that if you change your story, you can change your state. These are beautiful approaches.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.